Imagine that you write the code to save the player's progress for your C++ game. And while the game is saving the data, the PC suddenly terminates the program. This will leave your save file corrupted and the player will lose all his progress. In this video, I will show you how we can prevent that, and you'll be surprised to see that it is easier than you think. Okay, so why would the program suddenly close? Well, maybe the player just forcefully closed it through Task Manager while it was saving the data. Or his PC ran out of power. Or it crashed. Okay, so it is possible, but now you might say that it is probably so rare that it could only happen to 1% of the players. Well, if there are 2000 players trying your games, that means 20 negative reviews on your Steam. So 1% is a lot in this case. So let's see how I save the data for my Steam game. For this, I have my own saving library, called SaveSave. And I will show you the concepts using this library. The first thing that I do is I split my saves into multiple files. This is just a design choice, but now think about this scenario. The progress file is alright, but the volume settings file magically disappears. Well, it's not an important file, so I can just reset the sound settings. What if the game progress file disappears? Well, in that case, I better reset all of the files, because I have to reset the game progress, so it is better to reset the entire game to not risk getting into an inconsistent state. How can we avoid getting there in the first place though? The first functions from my SaveSave library are read entire file and write entire file. I like this pattern because it is easy to save and load structures in binary, and it is very fast because you tell the operation system once to dump all of the file content in one go. But you can possibly detect if a file gets corrupted.
Or can you?
For this, you can use a hash. Think of it like this. Take all of the file bytes as integers and add all of them. You'll get a number. This is called a checksum. Append it to the end of the file. Whenever you load it, compute that sum again and check if it is the same as the value saved at the end of the file last time. You probably noticed a flaw here. Because I am compressing a lot of data into one small number, multiple files could have the same checksum. This is true, and this is called a collision. This is why you should always use a hash function from the web instead of making your own one. This will drastically reduce the chance of encountering a collision. Because of how hash functions work, for a collision to occur, the two files would have to look very different, making it impossible to have a collision just by randomly flipping some bytes. Okay, now here is the trick. After I add the checksum, I also create a backup for each file. So let's think of this scenario. I first save my file, and I will get two copies of it. Next, I start doing the second save, but it suddenly stops midway. In this case, when I try to load the files, the system will detect that the first file is corrupted using the checksum and load the backup. If the save stops while saving the second file, well, the first file is good anyway. Now, if the save has been broken twice in a row, we can't recover anymore, but that case is really extremely unlikely. If the player, for some reason, decides to mess with both of my files, well, I can't do anything either. But at that point, it is his problem, not mine anymore. The library also has a file mapping function, and if you are curious how to do that yourself, check out this tutorial for my Windows API series. Also, if you want to help me, share this video with a friend. See you next time.